गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, आई विल बी रिव्यूइंग द मूवी अ मॉकिंगबर्ड. इट इज द मूवी फ्रॉम द लेट 90s 1990. इट डील्स विद द अबाउट द रेशियल डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. द फैक्ट्स ऑफ द मूवीज आर लाइक दैट देयर इज अ मैन हु हैज बीन फॉल्सली एलिज्ड फॉर द रेपिंग ऑफ अ वाइट वुमन, एंड अ मैन द प्रोटैगनिस्ट हैज बीन डिफेंडिंग हिम अराउंड द defending him from the evil clutches of the white societies that they think that is the black men are basically evils and do the notorious things and the crimes. So I will be dealing this thing scenario by coming to the various case scenarios of the various scenarios of the Americas, because it is most prevalent in the America. So I will like to draw the attention that there was the concept of white supremacy in the America, and in 1966 it was the motto of Alabama Democratic Political Party also. So what is the white supremacy? Was the white supremacy was the basically the supremacy of the white people over the privileges, the rights, and the every kind of the privileges which we can see are given only to the white people, and the black, or we can say that American Africans, are treated as the second class citizens of the United States of America. It has the state of America has the Naturalization Act in 1790, which only permits the citizenship to the white peoples and doesn't give any citizenship to the black peoples also. So there are the black peoples have to fight a long battle to get their rights. They always have to protest for their rights. And now we can see in the current scenario of the incidents of the George Floyd. Still now they are fighting for their rights, that they are being brutally beaten up by the whites. They are being destroyed by the whites. So it is the grave scenario which has to be taken into the consideration. Its effects is also came to be seen into the India also. Like we have the current news about the Hindustan Unilever and the Imam, that they have removed the word fair from their creams, Fair and Lovely. Just because of this issue has been raised. And another issue I would like was the Shaadi.com website. It has the filter which shows it shows the filter of the white, means a fair color. And it has been removed when someone has raised this issue on the social media, and then the company has removed that filter. So I would so it was the issues that we are dealing in this current scenarios about the racial differentiation between the peoples. I would like to draw the case of the Loving versus Virginia in 1976. It was the landmark case of the USA, which has changed the laws of the anti-racial marriages. What happens actually in Americas, the anti-racial marriages are not allowed. If the white women loves the black women, either they are being beaten up or they have to be feel the atrocities of the societies because they are interracial. So in this case, the Supreme Court has unconstitutionalized this constitutionalized that anti-racial marriage case. And coming to the present scenario, in the present scenario, I will back to the raise of the issue of RAM, the rise above movement. In this, the white peoples have made the indictments which are dangerous and cause the riots and the outbreaks in the country. But they didn't. But they were left out from the legal proceedings and not were punished. But on the other hand, the famous person, Day Ray Maxon, who was the one of the organizer of the hashtag Black Lives Matter movement, was sued. Though he didn't make any such statements which can be cause the outbreak of the riots. But on if we see that there is still a difference between them, since the white man who's making the deceit, who are making the speeches which are riotous in the nature, and the black man who is making the speech which are not righteous, still then the white man is left behind and the black man is prosecuted. So it is the battle that blacks always have to follow, have to fight for their rights. Recently, I was seeing a TED talk from TED talk. It was of the Columbus. There was a person named the James White Jr. He told about his life stories that how being an army person, Air Force army person, still he faces the atrocities to get the house in the cities where the white peoples are living. He said that every time the people says that there is the home, and he call on the phones. But as soon as they reach to them, they says no, we don't have the rooms, we can't rent anything. So he faced that still there are the clutches that that the person, black persons, Africans are facing towards the white peoples. White peoples. And according to the Valuna University study, it was said that the lighter shade persons get less punishment than the whiter shade than the black shade persons. So it is also just a discrimination. If a person is making a same offense for which the punishment is the same, then why this racial discrimination is going on? So I would like to show you the histories of the events where the blacks have to fight for their rights. I would like to bring the scenario of the Red Summer of 1919. It was the first wave of the movement when it was the time after the World War One. White peoples are brutally torturing the black peoples. They are making them slaves. So there was a business in 1921. They have torched a black man's business named as the Black Wall Street, and it was 300 people who were died, and many people who are have to leave their homes and to leave. Left that place. Still that the police didn't bring the blind eye towards the white persons, and they only arrested the black persons and prosecuted them. Then the second wave of it's become after the Second World War, where the in 1941 the black there was the black there was the leader leader A. Phillips Randolph, who demanded for the equal jobs for the blacks in the government due to which the president have to, under which president have to sign and made a committee of the fair have to made the employment fair committee, in which every person should be get selected irrespective of their color. Then the second scenario comes of the 1943. It was 1943. It was also a black day, and it was also considered the similar as the Red Summers of 1919, because in this the blacks were getting the jobs in the militaries and different companies, due to which white people have to face competition, and they were not happy with the jobs given to the blacks. So they have burned the houses of the black people. They brutally beat them, and this led to outbreak of same similar circumstances as it was happened in the 1919 Red Summers. They are being discriminated that black people cannot go to the restaurant where the white people go to restaurants. Then in the night, so regarding this issue, have came for demanding that desegregation of the restaurant on the basis of the colors like black and white. And in 1968, he was assassinated because of his movement, because of his support towards the black people. And now, coming to this present scenario of 2020s, it is just resemblance of the 1960, 1999, 1919, 1943, and 1968, which were considered the black days of the America, where the blacks have fought for their rights. And so, I will conclude by saying this, that same in the picture, in the film, To Kill a Mockingbird, it was shown that blacks have to face the atrocities still. As in the picture, the white woman was basically tempting the black person for the sexual desires. But the black person opposed. On the other hand, the husband of the wife had seen her. So she to save herself, she prosecuted the black. And the people always, people and that time thinks that blacks ब्लैक्स आर ऑलवेज इन्वॉल्व इन द इवल थिंग्स एंड आर द क्रिमिनल्स एंड इट इज वन ऑफ द थ्योरीज मेंशन बाय द लियोनार्डो इन हिज बुक लियोनार्डो एम ब्रेन्स ही सेड दैट द डार्कर द कलर इज द ग्रेटर द पनिशमेंट वुड बी He said that in his books, it was the thinking of people at that time. And in the Indian scenario, though there are not various NGOs, but still there are. I have counted two NGOs which are fighting for the blacks. One is led by the Kavita Emmanuel, who started the slogan "Dark is beautiful," and the another is a Bangalore student boy who started a NGO named as the Proud and Brown, Brown and Proud. It was the in India. These are two NGOs which are fighting for the blacks, or if they face any problems. Thank you.